Welcome everybody to another episode of our comprehensive training series called SAP Knowledge Booster. For this video, I have the pleasure to hand over to you today's presenter, Klaus, who will talk about the next hot topic with the SAP CSAM backup software. 3, 2, 1, launch.
Yes, thank you, Katrin. And I have the pleasure to talk about a really cool topic because I'm talking about backup of HCL Domino. This is quite a famous groupware product, and a lot of companies, huge enterprise companies essentially, are doing their mailing and sometimes also collaboration with this mighty product. I have prepared only a couple of slides, and then I will start with a really cool live demonstration to show you all the functionality of SAP CSAM. So let's start. If we talk about the Domino history, if you are a Domino user, you might know that actually it was invented by a company called Lotus. So this term is still around if we talk about Domino. There's also the term Lotus, even if IBM already has removed this name from all the Domino components. IBM has acquired this company, Lotus, in 1995, has called it Lotus Domino, then IBM Domino, and then it was sold to HCL in 2019. And I think that this was a kind of a rough sea for Domino. However, during the last year, I would say HCL has done a fairly good job in creating a new roadmap and giving back the self-confidence of the customers that Domino is still alive and it's working. And even if a lot of our competitors in the backup market has stopped to support the backup of Domino, we are still doing it. We are doing it not since yesterday, we are doing it since many years. And we are pretty up to date with our support matrix and also with the functionality. And we will do this in the future as well, as you can see. So what are the benefits if you use our software for doing a backup with your Domino, of your Domino groupware product? Of course, our extension, our module is based on the official Domino backup API. And from a version perspective, the current version is Domino 11. This is already in our support matrix. And we have already talked to HCL because there will be a new version, Domino 12, I guess still this year. And with our SAP software new version, we will also support Domino 12. So we will be one of the first having the support of Domino 12 in our software as well. Yeah, we have restore wizards in the GUI. And in the web UI, the Domino restore will be also possible starting with our next version. Yeah, then we have some possibilities in the single item restore. I will show this in the live demonstration as well. We support a DAOS configuration, this kind of single instancing of mail attachments in a separate directory. We support partition servers if there are several Domino installations on one server, and we will talk about this in a second. If we don't talk only about the Domino extension, if we talk about the complete product, our backup software, SAP CSAM, then I can tell that we have a cool online documentation. Most of our customers are really satisfied of our online documentation. I will show this later on. And also of our high quality support out of Germany. If you have any problems, then normally you will get the competent help from my colleagues upstairs. Yeah, then our product for the market has the right flexible pricing. With our broad support matrix, we are absolutely future-proof for every heterogeneous environment. It's a software made in Germany with the best data protection regulations with respect to GDPR and other regulations. And therefore, we have a lot of satisfied customers. And one customer reference case is the company Sauter, which has a very heterogeneous environment, not only using Domino for their mailing system. They have Oracle, Microsoft SQL, MySQL, using our image backup for disaster recovery and so on. So you can see the figures over here. And this is something we are really proud of. Yeah, from a functionality perspective, regarding the backup, of course, we use the Domino API. Therefore, we have the possibility to do an incremental, differential, full or copy backup. And we support all the Domino versions if it's greater than 8.5. So there's a huge range of Domino versions we support with our software. You can do a complete or selected backup. So everything or only part of. We can do a transaction-based backup when the transaction logging is activated. We support DAOs, partition server, and this agent is available on Linux as well as on Windows. For the restore, you can also do a complete restore for disaster recovery purposes and so on, or a selected restore. And I really have to say that for the complete and selected backup, and also this one in the restore section, you need to have a deep knowledge of Domino and the processes, how the Domino databases work, because they are sometimes pretty complex. So if you make any errors during restore, you can really ruin your Domino installation. So you need to have some knowledge of the behavior of your Domino installation. And I will come back to this in the live demonstration as well, because therefore, we have some best practices and so on to make sure that everything works properly from backup to the restore. Yeah, you can overwrite or give it a new name. It's possible to prepare point in time recovery and use the DB recover tool for the point in time recovery, or you can do a single item restore. And I will show you how you can extract the mail via the Notes front end. Yeah, so for active Domino backup user, I would guess that this is pretty familiar. The Domino backup structure. The Domino structure is that you have a root directory for the installation. Normally it's the Domino data, and you have an admin user. And for this installation, you need one central file. It's called notes.ini, and when we do a backup, SAP SESAM is looking for this notes file. If it's in the installation path, then it's fine. If it's somewhere in a specific binary directory of the Domino installation, that's also fine. If the SESAM software does not find this notes.ini file, it will provide a warning, and you have to either provide the path to the notes.ini file, or you can set up a separate path backup for this file. But you have to do a backup of this file somehow. Yeah. Then we have the databases, which are in fact in specific files, essentially the .nsf files, which are the mailboxes, but there are much more files, respective a lot of databases. And then we have the transaction logs, and they are also important if it comes to incremental backup and point in time recovery and so on. But this is also depending on your configuration of your Domino logging, because there are also different possibilities. You could have a transaction logging, you could have a circular logging, and these are the different possibilities, and they have different advantages and disadvantages. We also support backup of the DAOs. configuration, and there are also two possibilities. You could have your DAOs folder inside the Domino installation path, and then it's part of an all backup of the Domino installation path. But if you have a separate directory, then you have to create a separate path backup task to do the backup of the DAOs directory. And even if it's part of the installation directory, it could make sense that you exclude it from the all backup of the Domino backup and set up a separate path backup for your DAOs directory, because this one can get really big, because there are all the attachments of all the mails, and very often they have separate directories with a separate storage where they put all these attachments. So this is also depending on your specific configuration. Now, if we do a full backup, we backup in an all backup the complete databases, all the files in the Domino data root directory, all transaction log files, all the notes.ini if we find it, and also the DAOs files if they are in the root directory. With the differential backup, we backup all the changed files, and according to specific rules, we also backup the NSF files. And here you can see we are also looking for the DBIID, the identifier of a database, and if this changes, then we also backup the NSF files. Yeah. An incremental backup is similar to a differential backup, but in addition, we also backup the transaction logs. And at the first view, this sounds strange, because you might think that the incremental is bigger than the differential, because there is much more in this backup. But if you have knowledge of Domino configuration, then you should know that to be able to do an incremental backup, you have to configure transaction logging. And with transaction logging configured, all the changes are in the transaction logs and not in the NSF files. So normally in the incremental, then the NFS files, they are not part of the incrementals, only if there are some major changes. But with transaction logging switched on, there are normally no changes in the NSF files. Yeah? And this is also important if it comes to restoring incrementals, and I will talk about this later. When doing a copy backup, then it's same as a full backup, but without the generation chain, it's outside of the chain. Yeah, so for the restore, we really have several possibilities. This is only an overview of the different options you have for Domino restore, because you can set options like do not overwrite existing items, and then it will not be restored. If something already exists, will not overwrite it. You can do a directory restore or single file restore of the Domino structure. This is something we will use in the live demonstration later on for a specific NSF file. You can do a disaster recovery of your complete Domino installation, and for that you also would need an image of your operating system so that you can set up everything on new hardware, restore the image of the operating system, and then do a restore of the Domino database. Overwrite existing items, this is something you really have to be careful with, and it has limited usability. I would guess it's only for databases that are not in use, so that you can overwrite them. Yeah, you can create new versions in alternate directories with new names. You could do a simple restore to a new target. You can do a single item restore or a point in time recovery, where you have to restore the databases and the transaction logs, and then apply the db recover command for point in time recovery. So I guess a lot of options for Domino restore, and they all require some insight into the behavior of Domino. Yeah, now let's have a look at the live demonstration, and I have prepared already a browser, because I would like to start with a browser to give you an insight into the documentation. So let's start with www.sapsoftware.com, and here this is our home page. And I would show you from the navigation the entry point into the wiki documentation, because that's the important landing page you will find here. We have the support matrix. Yeah, let's have a look at the support matrix. Yeah, and if you scroll down, we have the groupware products, and here we have the IBM HCL Domino server. If you click on it, you can see that we have already Domino 11 with LESSIF 15, with RHEL 8, with Windows Server 2019. So we are pretty much up to date with this. Yeah, here we have the video tutorials. You will find a Domino video in a couple of days, then in our playlist, in our Knowledge Booster playlist as well. And here in the documentation, if you scroll down, you have all our extensions, all our agents, and here is the Lotus Domino, and here are the pages how to configure, how to set up a backup and restore. Here, if you click on backup, you can find a detailed description and with the hard copies of the dialog boxes, how to set up the backup and all the requirements. So this is the documentation if you want to set up everything. Then I have already opened the graphical user interface of our SAP Sesam, and here you can see with the tasks by clients tab, we have lots of tasks and servers in our demo environment, and under groupware and Domino you will find two Domino servers, a Domino 10 environment and a Domino 11 environment. Domino 10 is on Windows Server 2016, Domino 11 is on Windows Server 2019, and we can also search here for Domino. Normally this makes navigation pretty much easier. And here you can see the tasks we have set up for the Domino backup. And if we click, for instance, on Windows, on the Domino 10 server, and do a new backup task, we want to create a new backup task. Then you have the task type over here with the Lotus Notes. It's still named Lotus Notes. Oh, I guess we will change this in the next version. You have our client browser available over this little arrow. And then you can see that on the Domino 10 Windows server, there's a Lotus Notes available. You can just click on it, and then you have the selected source. It's all, click OK, and now you can create this backup task. But it's also possible not to create a all backup. You can be more specific and set up a path over here, yeah, and enter a specific path, maybe only the mail directory or only the log directory. Or if you have created your own directories for additional databases, because you use it for as a collaboration system like SharePoint or something else, yeah, you can use Domino for these tasks as well, and then you can back up these directories, or you can exclude specific directories. Yeah, you can enter it by manually here, or you can also use our client browser to set up these directories and specify these directories. Just click on the Domino installation path, yeah, and then you can select what you would like to back up, maybe only the mail directory. Yeah, then you can see this is selected over here. Say okay. Now you have to switch to the notes backup, and then you can do a Domino backup via the Domino API of this directory. Yeah, that's how you can specify the tasks. So then we can do a immediate start of some backups, and the Domino 10 server has the transaction logging configured, so we can easily do an incremental backup. Now let's do an immediate start, do an incremental backup. Now where to put the backups, and all these Domino servers are also configured as a remote device server, as an RDS, so we can backup the data directly on this Domino 10 server. Yeah, we have a media pool for this. Now start, and now this backup has started. And the Domino 11 server, we have configured circular logging, therefore we can only do a copy backup, we cannot do an incremental backup. And this helps because with this configuration all the NSF files and other databases are always up to date. Any changes which are made in this Domino system are immediately reflected in the databases. So the databases are always up to date, which helps if it comes to restoring specific NSF files, that you can do a single file restore out of the Domino backup. And what's even more important, if this Domino installation is running in a virtual environment, you can do a VM snapshot, maybe a VMware snapshot of this virtual machine of your Domino server, and then do a single file restore from the VM snapshot. That's also possible if you have circular logging configured. So there are a lot of advantages if you do copy backups, and to reduce the amount of data you need for these copy backups on the storage, it would help if you switch on deduplication or use a deduplication backup target like a store once or something like that. And then you can really save a lot of disk storage even when doing continuously copy backups every day. So now let's start this copy backup also to the right media pool of this server. That's this one. So let's do a start. Okay, and now we have started these backups. Let's go to the backup view. Let's filter that we see the right tasks, and let's filter by the location. So here you see that this one has already been successful because it was only a little incremental backup, and it's only a small demo installation, and this one it only takes 1 or 2 minutes. It's not too long. So in the meanwhile, I can also show you the insights of our web UI, because it's also possible to use the web UI to have an overview of the active tasks. Go to monitoring and backups, the backups, and here you can see the copy and the incremental. Okay, they are both completed now successfully, and if you click on this you get more information about how long it took, completed in a few seconds, 3 minutes ago, end of lifetime is until 28th of May. So you see all these kind of information. You can have a look at the log files, at the trace logs, yeah, and you can mail all the log files directly to the support if necessary. So this is also a cool functionality to help interacting with our support. So just to give you a alternative how you can have an overview of all the active tasks. Now let's do a little restore, and we will do a restore of this backup we have done. Yeah, and I have opened the Domino 11 server already in a remote desktop window, which you can find here. And now we will restore a single NSF file as an example. Yeah, so open our restore wizard, select the latest backup. You see it's a copy backup, therefore the NSF files are up to date. Now click on next, and now we can drill down the directory structure, data, mail, and we will select Brian's mailbox. Yeah, Brian. We can find the life of Brian completely in this mailbox. And let's go to next. And then we will restore to the desktop to use this file. Only the file, not the complete tree structure. And where would you like to restore? Into the on the desktop. So we have to select the desktop. It's here under users. So here's the users. We only have the admin in our demo environment, and we use the desktop. Okay. So path backup, that's fine because it's just a single file. And you can see if we start the backup, here's an overview of the options we have selected, and start. Now the restore has been started, and the file will pop up on the desktop over here in a second. Yeah, that's now the restored file. And you can also use our web UI for the restores. If you have here the restores, yeah, it has already restored successfully this domino file, and you also have the overview of this restore in the same manner with the mailing options, with all the log files. So if something goes wrong during a backup or a restore, you can easily have a look at the log files if you do have all the permissions, or if something is not reachable or accessible, or network is somehow down, whatever reasons you might have, you can find in the log files over here. Fairly easy to manage. Okay, now let's have a look how we can restore single items like mails and other objects from our restored NSF file. And for this, I have already opened notes with a productive mailbox of Brian. And we are going to remove this mail from the live mailbox, put it into the trash. Then we go to the trash, we empty the trash. So this mail has gone completely. And to restore this mail from our NSF file, we just double click on the NSF file. And as you can see, this tab over here, it's the application properties. This is the file we have opened, and if we go to this one and look at application properties, you can see there is the file name of the root directory of the Domino installation. So this is the live box, that's the proof over here. Okay, and in the restored NSF file, you can see that this mail still is existing. So we can do a Control C, copy this mail, go to our live box and do a Control V, and then this mail has been restored from the backup to the live mailbox. That's how this works. That's all with our live demonstration for today. Let's go back to the presentation, because I still have another slide which is important for our experts. And as I have told you, We have the possibility with SAP to do a differential and incremental backup, but incremental backup is more a theoretical scenario. Now, why? And the reason is that there are commands available for Domino users, like the compact command or fix up command and others. And these commands change the DBIID. So every time you run the command, and there are best practices from IBM to run the commands like compact, sometimes several times a day, and it's always changing the DBIID. And if the DBIID has been changed, then the NSF files and other database files will be copied completely into the ink backup, which has the effect that, well, in fact, the incremental backup has almost the same size of a full backup or a copy backup. So there is not much difference, and it doesn't really make sense to do an incremental backup when using commands like compact and other commands, which changes the DBIID. So in this case, we would recommend to do copy backups every time, because it has the same size as the incremental anyway. And with the copy backups, you have the advantages that the NSF files are up to date, that you can restore single files without applying the transaction locks and so on. So you can have all these advantages in place. So overall, I hope that you agree that SAP is definitely the best solution if it comes to the backup of an HCL Domino installation. Well, so far from my side, Katrin, are you ready to take over?
Yes, of course. Hey, are you impressed of what you have heard until now? Then you might be interested in gaining more information about this powerful backup software. After our SAP specialist has talked a lot about a specific backup topic, during the next roundabout 4 minutes, I would like to give you a short overview of the general capabilities of SAP Sesam. I'm sure you will be impressed of what is really possible with this product. This is essentially based on 6 strategic columns. The first and most important topic is our huge support matrix. There is an agent available for almost every operating system, database, or application you can imagine. Market leaders as well as niche products, for example, for mailing, Exchange, or Copanel. Even a lot of older versions are supported, because all old SAP clients are still compatible and usable with the latest SAP backup server, for example, NetWare, or outdated Windows versions. The second strategic focus is our strong partnership with SAP. While being 2 German companies, we work together from SMB to enterprise, from Business One to S4HANA. SAP has the most complete set of certified agents for the SAP portfolio, including NetWeaver running on Oracle or MaxDB, Linux or Windows, HANA or ASE, known as Sybase. Moreover, SAP not only supports simple HANA backup via the backend interface, but also functionalities like multi-tenancy, housekeeping, scale up, scale out, HANA Studio integration, disaster recovery, and efficient performance by parallel HANA backend channels for backup and recovery. Third, we focus on our partnership with HPE. Besides the perfect fit with our SAP partnership, this means that we step by step integrate deeper into the HPE portfolio. We just released our HPE certified Catalyst integration, including Catalyst Copy and Cloud Bank Storage. More to come soon. As a fourth element, we are proud of our multi-hypervisor support. By supporting more than 8 hypervisors, we are a perfect fit into every virtual environment beyond VMware and Hyper-V, or in every multi-hypervisor infrastructure. Based on our Unix and Linux history, we have a strong focus on open source. This becomes apparent from our partnerships with Red Hat and SUSE, but also from the support metrics, where you can find agents for open source products like KVM, MariaDB, or Postgres. Last but not least, we see the market going cloud. With our Cloud Application Protection Service products, we help you to back up your Office 365, G Suite, Salesforce, or Microsoft Dynamics environment. With Office 365, we back up the full set of features like Exchange, SharePoint, OneDrive, public folders, and Teams. With SAP Sesame, it is possible to run completely in AWS, replicate to a public cloud via S3, or simply use Catalyst Cloud Bank Storage and let HPE StorONCE do the replication work. All these topics are covered in separate videos. Therefore, we can proudly state that SAP Sesame is the most powerful backup software. Well, if you are now interested in knowing more about SAP, you can find detailed information about market, sales, product, and company on our webpage. Profound technical information can be found in our large wiki online documentation. If there are any questions left, please do not hesitate to contact us via email to sales@sepsoftware.com. So, I'm pretty sure that I'll see you next time when you're back on Tube to boost your SAP knowledge again.